Hi everyone, today I'm going to explain about counter that is incremented by 2. In this class I'm going to explain about how we can write the Verilog code for that, and what is the hardware, and how we can write the test bench. Like that I'm going to discuss now. First you have to understand what is counter incremented by 2. Okay, this is the clock. This counter is sequential circuit. We required clock for that. I'm drawn some of the clocks here. See that if you observe properly, each clock edge your counter is incremented by 2. How you are going to design that? Okay, see here, in first clock is 0 and next clock it will be 2, in next clock 4, next clock 6, next clock 8, next clock 10, next clock 12, 14, after that 0. Why it is going the 0? Because my counter with 3:0. 3:0 is maximum value 4 ones, correct? In 4 ones only maximum value. Suppose next number it will not coming here. What is the 14 value? 1110. 14 value is this one. If you convert to binary, if you add 2 for this, what output you will get is 0. It will go carry 1 here, 0. It will be 11 again 0. Again 11 it become 0 again carry is 1, but in 4 bit counter we can store only 4. That's why this value will be converted to 0 only, because after 14 plus 2 is 16. 16 representation is 140s. 140s means what happened? This MSB bit will be ignored because your register output will be 3:0. Okay, got it? If suppose 4:0 here, then you will see 16 here. Like that you can go further. Okay, now I taken 4 bit counter, that's why that counter width will be 4 bit. That's why this is after 14 it will goes to 0. Okay, this is the waveform I explained here. Then how you can write the Verilog code for this? Okay, here I am writing the Verilog code. Module counter, module name, you know the counter, bracket open, and then input clock comma input reset comma output counter 3:0. Count here you have to write 3:0 counter bracket close semicolon. This is a module definition. It is telling clock and reset is the input and output is counter, that is 3:0. These values will be coming to here. Okay, here I am using always block here, always yet pause edge clock or negate reset. If not off reset, count less than or equal to 40B000, else count less than or equal to count count plus 40B2 semicolon 4B D2. 2 means decimal number, right? If you write B here, 40B0010 you have to write. If you write D here, 40D2 is enough. Okay, that is your wish how you are going to implement here. Okay, if you see here, you used always block, you don't count here. Count is what? Always block, always left side variable will be reg. That's why you have to declare reg here, reg of 3:0. What is that count? This is count. I declared count here, counter is there. That's why I am assigning counter counter, counter is equal to count, count bracket code. Count means this, counter means output. This count is assigned to counter, this counter value goes out. Okay, this is end module. This is the counter code. How it will work? I will tell you. You need reset also. Reset will be behaving like this. Okay, think like that. This is the reset behavior. 0 to 1 is changed. This is reset. See that if suppose reset is not like this, okay, reset is like this, okay, because if you generate like this, your counter will be start will be incrementing here, because in pause age reset is 1, then automatically this one will be, that's why I change the reset is like this, okay, reset is like this, then this edge is 0, reset is 0, that's why counter will, next edge reset is 1, that is increment by 2. This reset is 0, then count is 0, else count equal to count plus 2. Okay, it means that in reset is 0 here, that's why count is 0. When reset is 1, then count equal to incremented by 2. Again, what happened? Reset is always 1. This is incremented by 2. It is going to here. After that, again 14 is 0. We are not resetting here because 14 plus 2 is 16. 16 is 140. So you have only 3 bits here. You have only 3 bits here. The 4 bits here, that's why 4 bits only here, this carry will be discarded, okay. This is the counter code. How you can write the test bench for this? This is 1.v. You can develop one test bench.v that has module test bench test env. It doesn't have any inputs and outputs. From test bench, what you have to do, you have to generate the clock and reset. That is enough. If you generate clock and reset, then automatically counter will be incremented. Okay, that's why what you have to do, you have to do this instantiation in the module TNV. Okay, what is the module definition? Is counter here. I am writing counter. Then I have to write instance name counter, u counter. This is the instantiation name, and bracket open dot of CLK, bracket open bracket close comma dot of reset, bracket open bracket close comma dot of counter, bracket open bracket close, then bracket close demicolon. This is the counter instantiation. If I put x here, what you give x here, that will pass to clock. If you put y here, what you will give y, that will go to reset. Got it what I'm trying to say? If you drive x from test bench, same thing, it will go to the clock. Then what you will write at y, that will go to reset. Okay, this counter, because you have to drive the inputs, then outputs will be generated automatically. That's why I'm driving clock and reset. Output will be, you can tap and see it. Now if you see it, I have to generate the x. Now x, how I can generate clock? You see the syntax of always -5 x equal to not x. If I have written, what will happen? Initially, I didn't write any value here. See, always -5 x equal to not x. Initially, I didn't write any here. Anything is here. Correct. Initially, what is the x value? I didn't write anyway. That's why I took initial block. Initial begin x equal to 0 and y equal to 0. I have written. Okay, then what will happen? Initial x equal to 0, then this will be incremented by every 5 units. Initially 0, after trying 2 minutes it is 1, again after 5 time units it is 0, like that. Then like this, what is the width of this is 10 ns. This is suppose 5, if you see this is 5 ns, then this total width will be 10 ns. How 10 ns? Initially 0. Initially x is 0, after that it is inverted, it is coming to here. Then after time units, it will go to 0 again, 1 again. After 5 2 minutes, it is 0. One clock pulse, it will take 10 ns. If 10 ns is there, you have to keep it 5. If you as per this one, if you see that initial will block will be executed initially, it will assign x equal to 0. Then this always block will trigger always. That's why it generates the clocks to this module. Then what about y? Y, if you observe here, I have to give like this. Like this, what happened? I have initially 0, then after some time I have to assert the reset. That's why not reset asserting here. Here I am asserting y, because y is connected to reset. That's why I am asserting y now. After 5 time units, you can write after 7 also. You can write here. Then y equal to 1. Begin here. Begin already is there. End here. Write end module. what will happen? X is initially 0. This will generate the clock to this module. And Y initially 0. Then after 5-7 time units, it will assign to 1. Then what will happen? This is only waveform behavior, right? Here 0. Here after some time, it will assert it. Then you want to finish the environment. Right here, suppose here in this point, you can write it. In this point, you can write it. What you have to write here? Yash 10,000. 10,000 time units, you write dollar finish inside initial block only. Okay, initial block only, what you have to write, yes, 10,000. After 10,000 time units, your simulation will be finished. Got it? What will happen? This initial statement executed and will stop the simulation. Okay, then here x is there, initial block inside you used it, always block also you have to used it. That's why you have to write regex here, reg y here. Why you have to write reg x and reg y here? Because initial block you used it x and y, that will be must be in reges. That's why you have to use reg x and reg y. Then I am repeating the code, how you can write it. Module test nv bracket open bracket close semicolon. There is no input for test bench. We have to drive this counter inputs from the test bench. That's why I did the instantiation and clock is connected to x. X is connected to clock, y is connected to reset. That's why x need to be driven from the clock, need to be generated, that will be connected to clock. Initially x equal to 0, always hash 5, x equal to not x semicolon I've written, then it will generate the clock to clock here. Then you have to write initially x equal to 0, because otherwise clock will not be generated, because initial value only this always block will trigger. Okay, initial, then x equal to 0, then it will trigger automatically. Then y also declared to 0, because my test bench is reset is 0 initially, after some time it is goes wrong. That's why yes 7 I given, I get in the I yes 7 I given, after that y equal to 1. It means that after 7 time units y equal to become 1. Y become 1, that is connected to reset, that's why reset become 1 here. Okay, then this simulation will we have to end it after some time. That's why what you have to do, I given yes 10,000, given dollar finish and end I given. Then after 10,000 timestamp, this simulation will end. 10,000 timestamp means this is each clock will be 10 ns. This 10 ns into suppose 1000 clocks will be generated. After that only simulation will end. Okay, this is the counter incremented by 2 Verilog code and test bench. Then I want to tell you the hardware also, how the counter will be there. This is asynchronous reset counter. This is the flop. It has a DQ. It has, what is the width of this? 3:0. Then this is the clock here, reset also connected. This is asynchronous reset flop code. This counter, what will happen? This count value, it will go to one adder. This is adder. Adder means this count value, another input tied to +2, tied to 2. Then this 2 and this counter value will be added. This is adder. Then this adder output is connected here. Okay, initially count, adder has 2 input, right? One input is this count value, other input is this 2. Another input is this 2. Then what will happen? This 2 and this count value, initially 0, this 2 will be incremented, again coming here, this is 2 will be now, again 4, like that it will coming here. How many flops is here required? How many flops? 4 flops will be required, 1 adder will be required here. Okay, this is the hardware for that one. If you want what is exact hardware, we have to go for KMAP and do it. Present state will be 0, next state will be 2, like that you have to write it and do the KMAP, finally you will get the hardware of this. But as per Verilog code, what is the hardware is, there is a flop, it has DQ, that flop output will be 3:0. It means that 4 flops is here and this is connected to 1 adder, this is +2, this is connected here. The adder output is connected to D input. That's it. Okay, thank you.